second extra class of English. I must say this is compulsory class, not extra. That's why I wrote compulsory. Fine, because this is a new syllabus which we are doing. Already we have completed that. Why the name of the chapter was kept Ranga's marriage. We have read about that. Fine. And then description of village Goshali. Author has given detailed explanation about the quaint description, you can say beautiful description of this village Goshali, which was situated in Mysore, but now it is in, yes, which state? Karnataka, yes, right. We need to remember the facts. So we have read about this. Now we will be reading about Ranga's homecoming, Ranga's views about marriage today, today's value points. And then the narrator finds a match for Ranga, and the name of the girl is Ratna, right? And the narrator arranges each between the two without their knowledge. They, both of them, they do not know that narrator has arranged an accidental meet that by mistake they have just met in that. Fine, so we will be reading. Let's see if we can read better.
Yes, yes.
Fine, and yesterday I introduced characters to you, Ranga, narrator and Ratna. Fine, and two more characters I am adding. Ramarao and Shastri. Shastri is the village, you can say, the way we say priests are there, pandits are there, Shastri is there. People need Shastri to get their things done in the religious ceremonies and all. The people who go for your birth what we call the Kundali and all. Fine. So then Ramarao is there. His uncle of Ratna. Actually, Ratna is residing at Ramarao's house. She is not living with her parents. Fine. And the detailed explanation we will be reading. How she is residing over there, how she comes to meet Ranga for the first time, and what happens afterwards. Fine. So we already know that. Let me give you the brief description for those who were not present, and very brief, so that you can connect. The story is about this character Ranga. Fine. He belongs to a village Goshali, which was situated in Mysore. Fine. And it is a beautiful place. It is a South Indian village. Fine. Typical South Indian village, and the author has described the village beautifully in the two pages that I will not discuss. Fine, you can see the lecture. Then, after that, Ranga is the accountant's son in the village. So, in the village, most of the people are not that educated, you can say. They might be literate, but they are not educated. So, Ranga is the only one who has gone outside the village for higher studies. He has gone to Bangalore. To a metro city, not abroad, right? So it was a very big event for all of them. So when Ranga comes back after completing 5 years of studies, everybody gathers like a flock over there to see whether Ranga has changed or not. So that's why Ranga's homecoming was a great event. This is the NCERT question also. That why Ranga's homecoming was a great event. Fine. Why it was? Firstly, he has completed studies. Nobody has done so. Secondly, people wanted to see, they were curious to know whether he has changed the way he talks, the body language, or maybe they were thinking that they might have, he might be dressed up in a different way, or he might be speaking in a different way. So they wanted to know what has the change come over upon him, right? So that's why Ranga's homecoming was a great event. We will discuss the questions, but I'm just giving you a brief description. Clear? So now, talking about the theme of this chapter, this theme is basically, it is a conflict between traditional thinking and modern thinking. Fine, so this chapter is going to tell that people, you can say arranged marriages versus love marriages also, but that is not exactly the way it is. It is about tradition versus modernity, because it is not only the one thing marriage, only multiple things are there in this. So Ranga, after visiting the metro city, he has changed. Nobody is listening. My voice is not audible. I was audible to you all. Nobody of you. How many? 9 students are online. Okay, so it means I was audible to you. You're saying yes. It will be more audible. Fine, I forgot to wear the mic today. So I was discussing that after discussing the beauty of the village,
Like why Ranga was so, you can say, important there, because he has gone to Metro City, he has completed his studies over there, people wanted to know him. Now his viewpoint about the marriage has been changed. In the village, people believe that one should get married at very young age only, especially girls, even at the age of 11, 12. So that was the scenario at that time, fine? So this is true. Child marriage concept is still in fashion. Fashion here doesn't mean, I mean to say, in some of the, you can say, the particular groups of society, stratas of society, they fix marriages when child is just 8 to 10 year old. Fine? In some of the communities, I'm not saying all, the people mostly, they are illiterate people, they do not know that the right age and all, though that's why government has set the particular age. So concept of child marriage can also be one of the themes of this chapter. Clear? But they have not concentrated upon it at all. In the whole chapter, they have not concentrated on child marriage. Fine? That I believe that it should be, but it is not exactly. Fine? So, Ranga thinks that marriage should be there when you have right match, when girl is of your equal age. Fine? And you have mental match the way we think these days. Fine? Please close the door, friends. So, but narrator, he has been living there only in Hoshali village. He does not believe in the, he says that I can find, or the parents can find the best match because they know you and they know the other person also. So narrator has seen a girl named Ratna and he says that this girl is quite suitable for this boy Ranga, and he knows Ranga also is very well acquainted to them. You can say one of the family friends. They have not mentioned what exactly the relation is. But yes, he is known to Ranga and Ranga respects him, the narrator, a lot. Fine. So he has found a match, Ratna. He arranges a meet at Rama Rao's house, or you can say at whatever we are going to read. Clear? Clear, I guess, Vansh? Sahaj, you were there in the class yesterday. Everybody has attended. Fine. So let's continue. We were on page 19, we have done. 17 we have done, 18 we are. So we can start from the last paragraph of 17. What I'm going to tell you is something that happened 10 years ago. We did not have many people who knew English. So after describing the beauty of the village Hoshali, now we are going to read about Ranga's marriage. So narrator has told us that happened 10 years ago. So this narration goes, dates back to 10 years. When narrator is telling us, it means he is going back to 10 years. We did not have many people who knew English then. Our village accountant was the first one who had enough courage to send his son to Bangalore to study. So underline this. That's why Ranga was considered important, because he was the first person to go to Bangalore for higher studies. It is different now. There are many who knew English, who know English. During the holidays, you come across them on every street talking in English. So he's saying that I'm talking about 10 years ago, but now in our village, there are many people who have done higher studies and who speak English. So during holidays, when they come back, you can hear them talking on the streets, okay? Those days, we did not speak in English, nor did we bring in English words while talking in Kannada language, right? So because I already told you South Indian accent they might be having, South Indian village it is. So they speak Kannada language. So he's saying that at that time, 10 years ago, when Ranga went for higher studies, at that time, English was not common. People neither speak English nor they used any English words. So that was very uncommon. Kisi ko English nahi aati thi, it means. What has happened is disgraceful, believe me. The other day, I was in Ram Rao's house when they bought a bundle of firewood. So this is one of the incidents which is not connected to Ranga. This is connected to the English language. That how even if by mistake somebody has used some word of English, people would not understand it. So this is one incident of that. Clear? What has happened is disgraceful. The other day, I was in Ram Rao's house. Aagya character aapka Ram Rao, because he's known to him. When they bought a bundle of firewood, Ram Rao's son came out to pay for it. He asked the woman, "How much should I give you?" 4 pais, she said. The boy told her he did not have any change and asked her to come the next morning. The poor woman did not understand the English word change and went away muttering to herself. I too did not know. Later when I went to Ranga's house and asked him, I understood what it meant. So this is one of the examples that neither narrator could understand the meaning of change, nor that lady who has come to give firewood. Firewood, you know that people, they were not having gases and cylinders at that time. They would buy firewood for the cooking for the whole days. And women, after cutting, you can say woods from the jungle and all, they would come and sell it on the each and every house. So that woman, one of the women, she came over there and she asked for money, 4 pais. And Rama Rao's son, he was able to speak some words. He said he does not have change. Change is English word. He chutte paise nahi hai. In that way, he did not use Hindi or Kannada language. So she could not understand. Even narrator could not understand. But narrator went to Ranga's house and asked him, what is the meaning of change? Ranga told him that this is the meaning. Okay. Then this priceless commodity, the English language, was not so widespread in our village a decade ago. Decade means how many years? Yes, 10 years. That was why Ranga's homecoming was a great event. Underline this now. Ranga's homecoming was a great event. How it became a great event? People rushed to his doorstep announcing, the accountant's son has come. The boy who had gone to Bangalore for his studies is here, it seems. And come, Ranga is here. Let's go. Have a look. Everybody was calling the other person to see Ranga. Attracted by the crowd, I too went and stood in the courtyard and asked, why have all these people come? There is no performing monkey here. Performing monkey, you know that you might not have seen it. Have you seen it, performing monkeys? Monkey shows, dekhe? That's very good. So you can relate. Today's generation, I guess, the younger kids, they are missing these things. So when you were kids, you might have seen, even snake charmers were very common. You know, you might have seen that also. So at our time, aur bhi cheeze thi. Even I have seen a bear show in my street. You might not have seen that. That is not common. Because when I was, six to seven year old, at that time I'm talking that I have seen bear shows also. And there would a man who would come fetching that movies, like it was a box and you just put your eyes over there and you would watch inside and there was just, actually it was pictures and the man would roll that thing and pictures would move and we would be so happy that pata nahi kya dekh liya humne. 1 rupee for hardly for 2 minutes or 3 minutes. In such kind of things we have seen. Fine. And I don't think so any of you have seen that. So there are many things. Fine. So he's going to that era when people would enjoy such activities, street activities, performing monkeys and all. So he's saying that why people are gathering here. So narrator is saying that it's not a monkey show going here. So why people are gathering to see Ranga? So when he got to know, yes, we were on. Okay, a boy, a fellow without any brains said loud enough for everyone to hear, what are you doing here then? A youngster, immature and without any manners, thinking that all these things were now of the past, I kept quiet. So when narrator said this, even narrator was one of the part of that crowd. When narrator said that, why you are here? It is not performing monkey here. One of the boys who was, you can say, loud enough to say, he said that, then what are you doing here? If monkey is not performing, why are you standing? So it means narrator was also curious to see Ranga. Fine. Seeing so many people there, Ranga came out with a smile on his face. So finally, Ranga is here. He came out. Had we all gone inside, the place would have turned into what people call the black hole of Calcutta. It means so many people were there. It was a huge crowd. So he came out of his house. Thank God it did not. Everyone was surprised to see that Ranga was the same as he had been 6 months ago. So he might have visited 6 months ago also. So they have again checked it that whether he's changed, he's same. When he had first left our village, an old lady who was near him ran her hand over his chest, looked into his eyes and said, The Janewada is still there. Janewada is Janeu. You might have seen a sacred thread. People wear white color ka, jo religious, I guess, priests and all hote hain. They always wear, not always, but in some communities, they wear called Janeu. Wo aise idhar se idhar dalte hain. Wo hamesha dal ke rehte hain. That is a sacred thread. Wo suchha dhaga hota hai. Fine. So they believe in that. So they have written also sacred thread worn by Brahmins. Fine. In Karnataka, in Mysore, over there. So Brahmins, they wear that. So one lady, this is very small incident, but it is giving us a big message that elderly people, they do not forget the roots. And she was not bothered about whether he has improved his studies or what he has learned. She was bothering that whether he has worn that sacred thread. Wo to nahi bhool gaya apna culture. So one of the old ladies, she came forward and she firstly looked into his eyes and she ran her hand over his chest to check that whether he's wearing. So she went away soon after that. Ranga started laughing. Usko laga ki means she's checking that. And Janewada is still there. So she was happy that he was still wearing it. What does it show when he was still wearing Janewada? You see, tell me. What does it show? Naman, are you listening? What does it show then? Anyone tell me? Yes, he has not forgotten his culture. He's still the same. Though he has acquired higher studies, we should not forget our roots also, whatever we become in our lives. Some people forget what they are. Some people forget, yahan se jaate hain, abroad jaake, they change. When they come back, they say, oh, what a stinky place it is. That should not be there. You have gone from this place only. Fine. So it should be that you should be very humble and grounded. Clear? Online children, am I audible to you all? Offline se zyada aaj online hai. Ishnur, Anjali, are you there? Fine. So now I'll be asking you also the questions. So be ready for that. Online children also. The answers in there. Once they realized that Ranga still had the same hands, legs, eyes and nose. So people were there that he's changed. How can a person be changed physically? So he was still the same. The crowd melted away like a lump of sugar in a child's mouth. See, this is simile. The way we put sugar in our mouth and it melts, similarly, the crowd melted away. I continued to stand there. I kaun hai yahan pe? Narrator, yes. After everyone had gone, I asked, how are you, Rangappa? Rangappa, is everything well with you? So this is the full name of Ranga, actually, underline this. He, then after everyone is gone, now narrator is asking about his well-being. Is everything well with you? It was only then Ranga noticed me. He came near me. He did namaskar respectfully, saying, I'm all right with your blessing. So that shows that this boy is humble. Fine, that he has not forgotten his roots. He did namaskar, he paid respect to him, and the narrator was happy to see that. I must draw your attention to this aspect of Ranga's character. So now you should know, he knew when it would be to his advantage to talk to someone and rightly assessed people's worth. It means he's saying that Ranga is smart enough to know that how to talk to someone, how to pay respect to someone, and he is able to assess the worth of the people. That you should give due respect to what people are expecting from you when you meet any person in your life. Do they expect anything in return? So they just expect that you talk to them politely, respectfully, and then they remember you always. The moment you become disrespectful towards anyone or behave in a nuisance way, and in that way, people will remember you in that way only. So Ranga is being known for his respectful attitude. Clear? As for his namaskar to me, he did not do it like any present day boy, with his head up towards the sun, standing stiff like a pole without joints. A beautiful description he has given. Jerking his body as if it was either a wand or a walking stick. Nor did he merely fold his hands. He bent low to touch my feet. May you get married soon, I said, blessing him after exchanging a few pleasantries, I left. Now, what he's trying to say, by making a comparison, by drawing the comparison between Ranga and present day boys, due to COVID, okay, we are avoiding to touch the feet of elder these days, fine. But before that also, he's saying that Ranga did not only just say, okay, the way you say Punjabis, what do they say when they touch the feet? Carry pona bolte, fine. Means I want to touch your feet. It's like a gesture that you respect your elderly people. And this culture is still prevailing in Punjab. I've seen many people, you know, touching the feet of the parents, grandparents, teachers, or whatsoever. So he's saying that Ranga folded his hands. He did namaskar to me. Not only that, he bowed down in front of me. He touched my feet. What a humble gesture it is. So he's saying this is not like any other present day boy. Jo other boys hai. How they react, other day boys? Keep on sitting with us. Close the door. So he's saying, standing like a pole, stiff, rigid. Aajkal ke bachche aise hote hain. Namaste uncle, uske baad udhar dekhte hain. Fine, they do not even touch the feet. Aur agar bolte hain, aise kar dete hain. Pari pona. Fine, that is the way where pari means foot. Without touching the feet, you are saying pari pona. Pona means I just touch your feet. You're not bowing down and you are expecting that this is the new fashion. Because we associate this is disgraceful. Ki main jhuku aur feet touch karo kisi ke, no way. So this is the today's generation. It is no harm when you touch feet and when somebody says God bless you or blessings. Agar nahi bhi bol rahe na, wo nikalti hai dil se. Elderly people will say how respectful the person is. So more humble you become. And I have seen the most successful people are the humble ones. Wohi hote hain jo wahan tak pahunchte hain. Fine, they are very humble. So it varies from person to person. So coming back to Ranga, Ranga is very humble person. Even after going to Metro City for his studies, he still remains the same. He's wearing his Janewada, Janeu. He's touching the feet of narrator. He's bowing down in front of others. He's folding hands. So that shows what trait does it of Ranga's character show. Just raise your hand. Now online children will speak. Offline ones are participating. Yes, online children, raise your hand. Otherwise, I will speak the name only. I talked to so many traits of Ranga that he bows down in front of others. Namaskara. And what does it show about Ranga? Yes. What does it show about Ranga? Yes, Divnu, speak.
And it shows that he was quite humble and respectful.
Yes, fine. Ishnu.
Ma'am, that he is still connected to his roots and knows the value of the traditions and the customs that is in his society.
Very good. Mitali.
Yes, ma'am. That he has not forgotten about his cultures and he had the respectful attitude.
Yes, very good. So, you got to know that everybody is clear about Ranga's character now so far. Clear? So let's continue. We have next period students are coming. Abhi 10 minutes padhe. See, so a man, then after that, what happens? When Ranga touched the feet of narrator said that blessing him, may you get married soon. So means after meeting Ranga, this question has entered narrator's mind ki iski to shaadi karwani. Fine, so that kind of person narrator is. After exchanging a few pleasantries like hi, hello, how are you and all. When you meet someone, you exchange some pleasantries, fine. So namaste, hi, hello, hola, all are part of these pleasantries, clear? That afternoon when I was resting, Ranga came to my house with a couple of oranges in his hand. A generous, considerate fellow. It would be a fine thing to have him marry, settle down and be of service to society, I thought. So narrator is having just one thought that I should get him married by all means, because when Ranga came to narrator's house having oranges, and he's very gentle, the way he talks, very, you know, it's a gentlemanly attitude. He says, इस आदमी को तो शादी कर लेनी चाहिए because he's very well behaved, well groomed personality. So I think he is suitable for marriage. Have you read the advertisement for marriages these days? Well groomed personality. That is one of the adjectives. When we will do classified ads, then I'll teach you that also. Fine. So he says ki I should make him settle now. For a while we talked about this and that. Then I came to the point, Rangappa, when do you plan to get married? After talking about few things, he comes to the point. What was in his mind? I'm not going to get married now, he said. Why not? I need to find the right girl. Now, beta, underline, this is the viewpoint of Ranga about marriage. I know an officer who got married only 6 months ago. So this is Ranga's thinking. He is going to give many examples that how marriages are failing like anything. Why? Reason is people are not having match. So rather than jumping into a wrong marriage without mental match, you get married and then you break up and then you get divorced. Better than that, you should find a right match for yourself. So he says, I need to find the right girl. I know an officer. So he's giving acquaintance, incident of an officer who got married only 6 months ago. He's about 30 and his wife is 25. Fine. I am told, means jo mujhe pata laga, he's saying. They will be able to talk lovingly to each other. Let's say I married a very young girl. She may take my words spoken in love as words spoken in anger. Recently, a troupe in Bangalore staged the play Shakuntala. There is no question of Dushyant falling in love with Shakuntala if she were young, like the present day brides. Is there? What would have happened to Kalidas play then? If one gets married, it should be to a girl who is mature. Otherwise, underline this line, double underline this line. If one gets married, it should be a girl who is mature. Otherwise, one should remain a bachelor. That's why I'm not marrying now. So in village, in Hosha Ali, this is the trend that one should get married with a young girl only. I told you, na, that girls, even when they are turning 10, 9, 8, 9, 10, 11, parents were worried of the marriage of the girl. That is child concept of child marriage, which is very wrong. So he says, Ranga is right in saying, he says that if I say, okay, I want to get married, definitely my parents will find a match for me who's very young in age. Because the trend in that village was like that only. If I spoke some words to her, she will not be able to understand what I'm trying to say. Because I am a mature person, she will be a very young girl. So that will not be right match for me. So I know an officer who is 30 and wife is 25, that is okay. Fine, 4 or 5 year gap is okay. But when you're having more than 10 year gap and 15 year gap, that was very common in village Hosha Ali, that is not acceptable, he says. So according to him, he says, I will remain bachelor rather than going for such kind of marriage. So this is the viewpoint of Ranga. Clear? If I have time, we have 2-3 minutes. So we will just finish this page, okay? Is there any other reason? So narrator is, you know, trying to know what he wants because he's having that girl in his mind. I will make him marry to that girl. A man should marry a girl he admires. Underline this again. This is the viewpoint of Ranga, that a man should marry a girl he admires. What we have now are arranged marriages. How can one admire a girl with milk stains on one side of her face and wetness on the other? What does it mean, I tell you? Or so young that she does not even know how to bite her fingers. It means he's saying that even at the very young age, wo kehte hai na ki dudh ke daant aaye nahi and you're just getting married in that way. He's saying that milk stains on the cheeks and she's still young, you know, biting the fingers, the childlike attitude, she's immature. And at that age, you are asking her to get married. He says, one a neem fruit, the other a bitter gourd. Means, why he has given examples of neem fruit and bitter gourd? The taste of bitter gourd, kya hota bitter gourd? Karela. Is it sweet or very, you know, how many of you like to eat, I must say? You are saying no. So he has given example actually to make us realize that if a person like this, one is so elder and the other is so young, this is a mismatch. right? According to Ranga, and he's right also. But how can such a huge difference between the two can be fulfilled? So one a neem fruit, the other a bitter gourd. Is this a match? Exactly, Ranga said, laughing. I was distressed that the boy who I thought would make a good husband had decided to remain a bachelor. After chatting for a little longer, Ranga left. I made up my mind right then that I would get him married. Even then, after getting to know so many things about Ranga and his viewpoint about the marriage, he says, "Iski shaadi to main nahi karwaungi. Chahe keh raha ki I will not get married." Because there he cannot find a right match, because in the village, this is not custom to fall into love with others and have equal marriages. And because all the girls by the age of Ranga, she are already married and having kids. Most of the girls are very young only, and their parents are finding right match for them. Clear? So Rama Rao's niece, a pretty girl of 11, had come to stay with him. She was from a big town, so she knew how to play the veena and harmonium. And she had a sweet voice. Bas yahi pe finish karenge hum, aage nahi jayenge. Because I wanted to introduce this character, Ratna. Ratna, she's a beautiful girl. She's 11 years old. She is niece of Rama Rao. Okay? She's not daughter of Ram Rao. She's niece of Ram Rao. She lives with them. She comes from a big town. Wo village mein aake reh rahi, but she's from a town. Town girl hai, but better than the village people. Fine. And she knew, that's why she knew how to play veena. Veena is musical instrument. Sitar jaise lagta hai, but ye sitar nahi hota. Mata Saraswati ke haathon mein dekhe kabhi? That is veena. So she knows how to play veena and harmonium. It means she is very good in music. And she sings beautifully. She's beautiful. She plays veena and harmonium. She sings beautifully. That's why they have written she had a very sweet voice. So these are some traits of Ratna. With this, I'm ending this. In fourth period, we'll continue, beta. Please do join. We have fourth period. Okay.